Here's what happens next.
Come
yeah,
on,
that's
man.
Not
they're
good.
Just kids.
No, they're not.
Yeah, we're kids.
This one is the fucking DA's daughter.
Yeah, you want to
right
mess
now,
with her?
She's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon,
come
on.
Who else is asking
down.
About her?
We're still talking. Everything's still cool.
Everyone asks about her?
Get crazy.
Oh, crap. Holy crap. She hit both of them? Wait.
Fucking bitch.
But she just hit him. Grab the knife, grab the knife, grab the knife. Oh no! Wait! Oh, and her arm.
What the fuck?
I'm like, I know she doesn't die before, you know. Art teacher. He's a freaking madman. Told you trouble. T-R-O-U-B-L-E trouble. Into the hospital. Just drive correctly, don't crash, get to the hospital. I don't know if she really knows how to drive that well. At this point, anyway. We've seen Max drive, right? I don't remember if we've seen Chloe drive in the first game. Jeez, like it's just blood loss? Yeah. That's scary as hell. Just because we asked about her mother. Did David tell that freaking psycho guy, or did he find out somehow? Yeah, it's been spiraling out of control. Yep. Guess we're not allowed in the room because we're not family. Oh, they're fighting the fire. I liked how the plant has its own chair.
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery.
Brachial artery?
Cut it.
In her arm?
She's had a surgery. And now she's resting.
Well, good. More red eyes here.
What happened?
Is it my fault? I guess it might be my fault. Not so quick to give myself up, so I'm gonna say I'm trying to figure that out.
I don't know. Everything happened so fast.
Damn right it did.
That guy you have a file on. Demon Merrick.
Demon, right.
Why does he hate you so much?
Try to put him away.
I know exactly. Who Damon Merrick is.
Yep.
Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I need the whole story.
I don't have a problem telling the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us.
Don't get a choice anyway.
Since you know Sarah.
Frank Bauer.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
Did he want to scare us away? He didn't want us asking him. He did want to ask about Sarah. And he did say why is everyone looking for her? Which means, as far as he's aware of, more than just us. So yeah, that to ask about Sarah, I guess.
He asked us why we were so interested in Sarah.
Right.
And what did you say?
Nothing. Of course.
It kind of escalated from there.
Is that how it became violent?
He wanted dirt on you, Mr. Amber.
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
Maybe he already knew. You know what? She just said Rachel. She said Rachel's name. She was talking to Rachel. So then he said, oh, Rachel Amber. I guess it was my fault then. I said her first name, not her last name.
I called her Rachel.
Right.
And you figured it out from there.
It's not your fault.
Well, I picked that option.
What happened next?
Damon had a knife out, and we all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off.
And yep.
She just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her.
She clonked him with a 2x4.
I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something. But when he attacked her, I just froze.
Yep.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened.
Well,
then we were here.
We saw Frank in the
first
game.
I appreciate you telling me the truth. I'll see if I can pull some strings with Ray. Maybe get you back into Blackwell.
Don't think that works. She doesn't go back to Blackwell. What is she doing when Max comes back in the first game? Nothing, right? What about Sarah?
What if Rachel still wants to meet Sarah?
After all this, I'm hoping she'll finally see reason.
Probably not.
I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have,
Oh, really?
Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world.
Why don't you...
It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
Why don't you contact Sarah? Mr. Attorney, and in a controlled environment, have them meet. What's the worst that could happen? As long as someone's there to watch over
them. Staff, how's Mikey?
Oh yeah, Mikey.
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Me too. Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay. Sure. Definitely.
I want to play some more D&D. Huh. Is that his brother?
I don't think I can sit still any longer. Might as well stretch my legs while I wait for Rachel to wake up.
Damn, I got a serious case of the munchies, and the vending machine is out of order.
Come on.
I know, right?
Not that I have any coins anyway. Oh, man. Jackpot.
He's gotta kick it just right. Slam it. Just like, I fell into it by mistake, I'm sorry. Did I get it? Damn it. Slam it again. It's the snacks. They're trying to get out. It's not me. Damn. Jackpot.
Yes.
Is that score bar?
I want like 20 more of those.
No can do. Sorry.
Pretty sure the hospital nutritionists meet here after hours and pig out. Mom brought so many of these home when Dad died, and not a single one described how I felt.
Magazines.
One more hour of waiting, and I would have read that.
Which one is that one? Mini Golf Monthly?
If I want to stay sane, I need to stay busy. What's there to do around here?
We can sit at the little kitty station.
Being in a hospital this long sucks.
Mm-hmm.
I just want Rachel to wake up, and then I'll feel better. I owe Frank big time. Can't believe he did that for us. I hope he's okay. Not like I can do anything about it one way or the other. And what about Damon? Is he gonna come after us? I actually feel better knowing that James Amber is on his case. Ugh. That's weird.
And now she just thinks nothing. Her mind is an empty void. On your feet. Wait. No.
Shit. I know those guys.
This doesn't look like the maternity wing.
You think?
Who are they?
If you're this useless now, what are you gonna do at 3 a.m. when the baby needs...
There's a sign for the prenatal class.
Great. I guess that's your contribution for today.
Ugh. Those people suck.
Who are they? Alright. I didn't want to trigger something. I want to look around as much as possible. Let's check out the memo.
Frank's business must be booming. Shit. I really hope he's okay.
He shows up in the... well... original. Which takes place after this. Attention, Arcadia Bay Hospital staff. There has been a recent increase in anesthesia complications from recreational drug use. Please make it clear to patients, especially those in their teens, that if they've taken any drugs, they need to disclose them to you for their own safety. Be persistent when taking down patient histories. Thank you. Well, no problem. You don't need to talk to her. She doesn't matter. Let's look at this letter.
Sean Prescott. What's he writing to the hospital about?
Is it followed up on what?
Is this for real?
Arcadia Bay Hospital Admin. Administrator Hofstadter, one of your current patients is Michael North, a student at Blackwell Academy who is injured on school grounds. As the physical safety of its students is a core responsibility of any school, Blackwell has failed Mr. North in this instance. I would therefore like to personally, and I stress anonymously, cover his medical expenses. If I may be of assistance in speeding the process, do not hesitate to contact me. Sean Prescott. Followed up on 59 WH Okay, off starter then. Yeah, that's weird. Guess he wants to have blackmail material against Blackwell Academy? Is that how he ends up being, like, in charge of it or something? Board of directors or something like that? I can't get be- Let me back there. I have important medical business. Oh, there's a poster. Oh, we can graffiti this.
If I want to stay sane, I need to stay busy.
I know, we're looking
this
at stuff.
This poster seems to be missing some context. What to draw, what to draw.
That's a good question.
Okay, nurses. The world wants to know. What's so funny?
Dirty joke. Watch the master at work. I'm so tired of dealing with assholes.
Cue laugh track.
Then you shouldn't have taken the proctology shift. That is funny.
Cue laugh track.
Okay. Done over here. How are we doing with these, by the way? Do I have another page? I do. You ever notice how people in hospitals are always whispering? I think it's because hearing our own voices makes everything feel much more real somehow. Like writing it down. Weird how only a few hours ago I was the one bringing something broken back to life. I snagged one of David's car manuals and fixed up the truck. I took it for a joyride around the junkyard before Rachel showed up. We chatted for a bit. Then shit got crazy. And by crazy, I mean Damon Merrick, the psychopath who's super interested in Rachel's bio mom and dad for some reason. He and Frank arrived, demanding to know what we were doing. Before we could find out why, he pulled out a knife and stabbed Rachel. I might have been able to stop him if I acted quicker, but I just froze. If it weren't for Frank... A blazing car ride later and I'm here, at the hospital, wishing I could make myself believe this isn't really real. Chloe, the much too real. P.S. I hope Frank's okay. This is what we actually like Frank at this point. I don't think anyone liked him in the main game. Donation box.
Guess the citizens of Arcadia Bay aren't feeling so generous.
No. Is that 100 though? Or 5? Guess that's a 5, yeah. The Arcadia Bay Fire Department needs your help. Your generous donations will help fight wildfires and keep firefighters safe. Thank you. Sorry, firefighters. Oh, missed this poster. Biohazard. Dispose of biohazard properly.
I wonder if Damon Merrick classifies as a biohazard. He's definitely human waste.
Zing. Alright. Let's go visit some people.
Is this Mikey's room?
Probably, because his brother's standing outside.
Is that Mikey and Drew's dad?
Oh, his dad.
I wonder how he's doing.
Oh, this is... Oh, that's freaky. Yeah, he's a little old to be the guy's brother.
All right, then. Thank you.
All righty, then.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
You here to see Mikey?
Yeah.
Sounds stupid to say how are things. Nice meeting you.
Well, it was nice meeting you.
So polite.
Likewise.
For her.
Oh, excuse me.
Alright. We'll go visit. Wizard teddy bear.
Chloe.
Hey, you made it.
It was only down the hall.
Hey, Chloe.
How's your arm?
Hey. How's the arm, Mikey?
I wish it was the other one, so I could draw and stuff. But other than that, it's just broken.
Mm. Sweet hair, by the way.
Thanks. I bet you could pull off Sailor Mercury.
Thanks.
Any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
How'd she get hurt?
You'll think I'm joking when I tell
you. Long story.
But I'm not.
Why? What happened?
Rachel was stabbed in the arm. By Damon fucking Merrick.
Yeah, these arm injuries are going around.
Yeah, that's not funny. Shit. You serious?
I was not kidding.
Fuck that guy.
It wasn't because of me, was it?
No, we have our own problems.
Oh, no. We got our own set of problems with him.
Public enemy number one.
That's crazy.
The whole thing makes me want to just... I swear, if I ever meet that shithead, I'm gonna...
What? What are you gonna do when you meet Damon Merrick?
Roll a natural 20.
Terrible.
Uh-huh. Mm.
I am.
Dragonfire.
Like...
Karaoke battle.
Challenge him to a karaoke battle?
Yeah, that's how we settle things on the street, huh?
Okay.
Throw dice at him.
Criticize his taste in film.
Okay.
Tell him about a band he's probably never heard of, but should have.
Enough!
One more?
Anyway, we're glad Rachel's okay. You should hang out here till she wakes up.
Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably head over when I'm ready.
Yeah, I'm not gonna stay here. Plus, probably nothing's gonna happen. We look around and then I'll go out back out to the, Carter, of course. What's this? A note? A note card.
Mikey's entering into a cartoon contest? I hope he wins.
Cool. Hope he doesn't have to draw anything else. Michael, success. I was able to get a medical extension for your entry to the Cascade Head Cartoon Contest. I think your superhero designs are the perfect spokesperson for marine preservation. Have a restful recovery, Miss Cole. Well, if it is fully broken, it's going to take 6 weeks to heal. How long does this contest go on for? Here's a letter.
Look at that. Wells being nice for a change.
Michael, I would like to express my deepest condolences for your injury. I strive to make Blackwell a safe and welcoming place for all students. I realize now in many ways I have failed to do that. Yeah, you fail at everything, Principal Wells. I want you to know that the students and faculty are rooting for your speedy recovery. Your absence will be felt by all here at Blackwell. I have made sure that your teachers are ready to accommodate any academic needs you may have. As for the matter that you were injured on Blackwell grounds, I can't help but feel personally responsible. I have begun to look for new security personnel. If there's anything I can do to make you feel more safe upon your return, please do not hesitate to let me know. Sincerely, Principal Ray Wells. Okie doke. We look at the whiteboard before I talk to them and stuff.
Mikey's nurses must love this.
Michael North. Yeah, admission date May 8th, 2010. Cause for admission, cyborg operation, uranium exposure, dragon bite. Medications, healing, a potion, 6 magic beans, a kiss from a beautiful woman. Attending physician, Dr. Bill Anderson. We didn't circle which pain scale. It's supposed to have a digit. It's supposed to be one, like all the odd numbers are missing. Can I, I can't graffiti that? I could even prove that even better, I bet you could. I can't actually talk to, speak to both of them? Steph and Drew.
Steph and Drew aren't leaving Mikey's side. He's lucky to have them.
Of course, with the exception of Drew on his phone, they're both just sitting around staring into space.
Is your shirt a fire cone?
That's right.
Sure. Why not?
That's one of my favorite spells. From our tabletop game.
That's You're a thinking spell? About tabletop right now?
Well, I am.
Of course.
I had to hide our game from the nurse.
Sweet!
She thinks it's negatively affecting my mood.
Can we play?
Elmon's backed himself into a pretty tight spot this time. He might not make it.
Wait a sec. Calamastia.
Yes.
She can join Elmon in battle. Maybe the two of us together could actually make it out alive.
Hell to the air.
You're into this nerd shit too?
Oh, come on, play with us. Totally. Totally.
It's a game where I win if I make up crazy shit and act like a badass.
That's right.
So, yes. I hate to be such a game master about it, but I'm pretty sure Chloe's character died last time.
Resurrection. Phoenix power.
Yeah.
Wait a sec. Didn't you have that anklet of reincarnation in your inventory?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
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 I totally did have that thing.
That's the
Holy
ticket.
Shit. So you can actually swoop in and save my ass.
Right.
What do you say?
And the rest of you. You betcha.
You gotta save Elmon, right?
I was hoping for this. Like I said before, guys, I would totally play a game of just this. Like,
we
playing
rejoin Elmon
game
as
in a game.
He majestically soars over the Traveler's Path. He glances over his shoulder, only to discover his pursuers are right behind him.
Dragonman?
Wait.
Dragonkin.
You can fly?
I'm a wizard. Plus, I kinda have to since you cut my feet off last time.
Oh, yeah. So funny.
Oh, yeah. I totally did that.
You totally did.
This game is awesome.
Elmon comes around a corner to discover Calamastia, the elf barbarian, sitting by a fire, roasting squirrels.
Roasting squirrels. Sup?
Sup?
Sup? I'm running from Dragonkin because of you.
Oh, it's right, it is Dragonkin.
Remember when you killed that jailer and took his key to free the prisoners in the prison camp? Turns out you offended their entire clan.
And they're after me now.
Need a hand?
Sounds like you could use a hand from your favorite elf barbarian.
Well, you did manage to inflict an insane amount of damage on everything.
Of course.
Suddenly, Dragonkin scouts rush in, clawing you while your backs are turned.
Hey.
Take 4 damage.
No initiative?
You're up first. What do you want to do?
I love this. Spinning slash?
I do a spinning slash.
16.
Not
Good
bad.
Enough. You spin around, using your axe to slash all 6 dragonkin at once.
Sweet.
They all drop dead in a puddle of blood.
Oh, that easy?
Hey, nice one.
Don't celebrate yet.
Okay.
You begin to hear the clinking armor of hundreds of Dragonkin warriors.
Hundreds?
The sound grows louder as they grow closer.
And this is why I was running.
We can take them.
Come on.
I hope.
You can totally take these fuckers down. I just killed 6 of them.
Those were scouts, Chloe. Warriors are 4 times that hard.
Oh. Well, shit. running and living. Yeah, sounds like a plan.
Looks like I picked the wrong choice.
As fast as you can until you come across a fork in the road. One path leads into the mouth of a deep, dark cave. The other takes you into a dense, misty forest. Which way do you go?
Feel it out? I'm tempted by the caves, I really am. Some dungeon delving would do us some good, but yeah, let's feel it out.
Can I, you know, feel it out first?
Totally. Roll for perception.
Okay.
19.
Oh, yeah.
You become still, channeling your elf hearing into the caves. Inside, you hear something moving around. Mm. It sounds squishy. And possibly very, very evil.
Okay.
Mudman?
Not the cave.
Gelatinous cube?
Got it.
Black pudding?
Not so fast. You now turn to listen to the forest. You hear the spirits of those buried there, whispering to each other. This is sacred ground.
Okay. Come on. The dragonkin are still behind us.
We're gonna fight a bunch of spirits or one squishy beast, evil beast. Let's go to the caves.
Maybe the dragonkin won't follow us into the caves. Let's go there.
I guess I don't have a better plan.
You plunge into the darkness. The uneven, rocky terrain beneath your feet makes it difficult to navigate. You come around
bump
the
into.
Corner to find a cube of bright green goo sitting in your path.
I knew it, gelatinous
dead
cube.
Dead rats float around inside it, slowly dissolving.
Of course. It's a gelatinous polyhedron.
Gelatinous polyhedron?
You fall into it.
Copyright issues? It's not
seriously?
A cube?
It starts to burn your skin.
Ugh.
A little at first. But the pain only grows the longer you stay stuck.
Yeah, we're being digested.
Scorching scythe.
Your flame-made scythe slices the gelatinous polyhedron in half.
That's a tongue
twister.
Freeing
your companion. But right before your very eyes, the two halves grow and shift until you're face to jelly with two full gelatinous polyhedra.
Face Damn. To jelly.
Your move.
Jeez, we're gonna. Why are they the same size? Why would they should both be smaller? They grew, right, somehow. Okay. Astral Axe would cut it in half again, I'm thinking. So striking smash, maybe we can just pulverize it into little bitty drops?
Striking smash. I'm gonna smash the shit out of them.
You bring the flat of your axe down over the polyhedra, smashing them each into three little globs.
Three little globs.
But yet again, the chunks
God.
Of jelly grow and shift until you're looking at a small army of six gelatinous polyhedra.
Damn it!
Where do you keep getting these?
A good game master is always prepared.